Hello students, very very good evening. Welcome in your classroom, and we are going to start 12th class physics, electric charges and fields. Yes students, in your previous class we have discussed many points related this. Yes, and of course that was point was the last. Then what was the last point? Field due to a uniformly charged thin spherical cell. A thin charge spherically cell. So, and that was complete the chapter, but something, some parts was remaining here. What was remaining? Just I am telling you. Yes. Well, first of all, I am just giving you an introduction for this. What is the chapter name? That is the electric charges. Electric charges and fields. Sorry. Fields. Okay. Yes. And last time we were discussing the electric field. The field due to a uniformly charged thin spherical cell. Spherical cell. Yes, and last time we have already discussed that what was the electric field was coming. Yes, when the field outside the cell, number one, just I am repeating this, the field outside the cell, outside the cell, that was coming, that E is equals to Q upon small q upon 4 pi epsilon 0 small r square with r cap, and this one, and how it is this? This is a spherical cell I am making for you. Okay, again, suppose that this is a spherical cell and a field is at a point, that is the P, and we make a what? A Gaussian surface for this. A Gaussian surface, and what was that? This was this in a sphere. Exactly, yes. Gaussian surface. Yes, and the second point was the field inside the cell. The field inside the cell. What was that? Zero. Because of there was no charge. Inside the cell, that there was no charge. Yeah, because that you can understand the field, the electric cell is this one, and the charge is outside. Exactly, yes. But in the inner side, there is no charge. There is no charge. So that's why there was no electric field. Okay, student. Yes, and. Now I will discuss with you the summary points for all these things. The summary points, these are so important, so that what are the needs to keep in your mind and what is the summary must be. That why I am reciting here summary. Summary points. What are the summary points? The electric and magnetic force determine the properties of atoms, molecules, and bulk matter. Exactly. Yes, yeah, no. Yes. Because of we were discussing in your electrostatic. Electrostatic. And that was I was telling you why the charge is feeling. Why it is going to charge why it is going to charge and how the charges is producing, the how the charge is producing and how can we a body we can charge. Yes, you know. Yes, exactly. And that was just only the due to because an atom has the what, electron and protons also. And from simple experiment of frictional electricity, one can infer that there are two types of charges in nature. Exactly. And two types of charges are positive and negative. And the conventionally what they are doing on a glass rod, if you are rubbing with the silk, it is a positive, and that on the plastic rubber with that it is a negative. Yes, exactly. And the conductors allows movement of electric charge through them insulator. Don't it matters the mobile charges are electrons in electrolytes, both positive and negative ions are mobiles. And the Coulomb's law and the electric charges has three properties. One is quantization, second is additivity, and the third is conservation. Yes, you know. And the what is the quantization? That Q is equals to Ne, where N is the number of the proton and electrons, and E is the electron or proton that it depend on the. And called the Coulomb's law. The Coulomb's law is that F is equals to K Q1 Q2 upon R square. Exactly. Yes. And here K is equals to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught. And what is the epsilon naught? Epsilon naught is the permittivity for the free space. And what is the value of K? That K value will be 8.854 into 10 raised to power minus 12 Coulomb square, Newton square, and Newton inverse and meter inverse. And the approximately K value that you know, what is the Boltzmann constant? That is 9 10 raised to power 9. Yes. And the superposition principle that you know about it, the what is the superposition principle? Electric field line, electric dipoles, and the in the relation in the dipoles, uniform electric field, the flux and the area element for this one, and the charge densities, and also the spherical, when we read out in the two ways, number one, the infinite thin, number one thin infinite long straight wire, there was the electric field was that electric field there was lambda upon 2 pi epsilon 0 r, and we have proved it. And the infinite plane sheet, if it is here, then the electric field will be sigma upon 2 epsilon naught with n cap. And the electric field in thin spherical cell, you know about it, that's Q upon 4 pi epsilon 0 r square with r cap. Exactly. And if r is greater than is equals to r, and if r is less than r, then it E will be 0. Yes, yeah, this was the summary point for this. Electric charges and fields. Now, students, we will start with your exercise. Of course, some parts of today we will discuss, and the remaining portion we will discuss in your next class when I will start with your next chapter. Okay? Yes. Why I am just telling you, I am just giving you the hint for this, and also because there is using the concepts exercise for chapter 1, using the concepts. Okay, yes, number 1, what is the question is here? Number one question. What is the fourth between two small charges spheres having charges of 2 into 10? Okay. First of all, what is the saying it? Force. Force. Okay. And if you are just say force, that it will be come in your mind about Coulomb's law. Coulomb's law. And what is saying the two small charge spheres having, okay, two small charge spheres, what is it? The one is 2 into 10 raised to power minus 7 coulomb, and the 3 into second is minus 7 coulomb, and how much distance between them? The distance is 30 centimeter, okay. And in air, the already is given the air means epsilon naught. And what is the force? What is saying? What is the force? Now, Coulomb's law we will apply. The what is the Coulomb's law? Yes. First of all, you will see here the everything is in given what? The everything is in the proper units, that of course that Q is in Coulomb, it's correct. But the distance is what? Centimeter. So we have to change in meter. That small r is equals to 30 centimeter, and if you are denoting in there in meter, that what will you can the 3 meter? Yes or no? Yes. Now the Coulomb's law, if you are applying, the F is equals to k q1 q2 upon 4 pi epsilon no sorry that k q and q2 upon r square. Yes, exactly. And you know that k is equals to what? 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught. Yes, and epsilon naught already given in here what? In a air, that you know already that this value is 9 into 10 raised to power 9. Yes, now we will have to put the value, then 9 into 10 raised to power 9 into how much? The q1 value is coming 2 into 10 raised to power minus 7 into 3 into 10 raised to power minus 7 divided by r square is given that how much? 0.3 meter whole square. Then you will solve this question. Hence the force between the two small charges spheres is, the charges are of the same nature. Yes or no? Yes, because one is positive and second is also positive, and the force will be what type? Repulsive, because the same charges are here, so they will be repulsive. Exactly. Yes. Now the what is the question number 2? Question number 2. What is this saying? It is saying that the electrostatic force on a small sphere of charge 0.4 microcoulomb due to another small sphere of minus 0.8 microcoulomb in air is 0.2 newton. Okay. Now, the question is saying that two small spheres, okay, this one. This is Q1 and this is Q2, and a force is applying between them. Exactly, electrostatic force is applying here F, एंड क्यू वन इज वॉट माइनस सॉरी 0.4 माइक्रोकुलम ओके और दिस वन इज नेगेटिव 0.8 माइक्रोकुलम एंड इन एयर ओके द एप्सिलॉन नॉट वॉट इज इन एयर and the force is applying how much that is coming 0.2 newton. First of all, then student, what is the missing here? That the missing thing is here, the distance. Exactly that we did not about the distance. So question first part is arising for that how we have to find out the distance. Second point is here that Q1 is positive and Q2 is negative. Then you can understand that one charge is positive and one charge is negative, then they will be attract each other. Yes or no? Yes. And now they come to the point that it is in what are the units is there? That there is a unit microcoulomb and microcoulomb. It's correct. But we have to change in coulombs also. Then we can take it 0.4 and in by 1 micro is 10 raised to power minus 6 coulomb. And the minus 0.8 into 10 raised to power minus 6 into coulombs. Yes, exactly. Now, what we have to apply? Same. We have to apply the Coulomb's law. And what is the Coulomb's law? That F is equals to Q1 Q2 upon 4 pi epsilon naught r square and f value is already given that I can just write in here 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 k value what can write 9 into 10 raised to power 9 yes newton meter square and coulomb square sorry yes yeah now f is given what 0.2 and the q1 and q2 then you can understand what is given 0.4 into minus 0.8 into 10 raised to power this I am taking that minus 6 and minus 6 minus 12 and what is then 9 into 10 raised to power 9 and divide by r square then we have to find out that r square can be take it right here yes or no yes and then we can find out the r square yes now the question second what is saying what is the force on the second sphere due to the first what is the force due to the first then you can understand the already given is here that due to the first and due to the second because what is the greater than this that the 0.4 is greater than minus 0.8 yes that's why exactly the force will be applying for 0.2 newton yes now the third question is saying check that the ratio ke square by gme me is dimension look up a table of physical constant and determine the value of this ratio what does the ratio signifies what does the ratio signifies okay so question number third is given here the ratio for this one what k e square divided by g small m e and m p exactly yes and you know when the g is gravitational constant g is gravitational rotational constant and the E square, you very well know what is the E, the electric charge. Electric charge. And M of E, what is the mass of electron? Mass of electron. And M of P means mass of proton. Mass of proton. Yes, exactly. And K, you know very well know that K is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught. And what is the value for the 9 newton raised to power? Newton, meter square, and coulomb raised to power minus 2. Exactly. Therefore, the what will be the, you will find the unit. Okay. K. What? Newton. Yes, Newton, meter square, coulomb minus square into electrons. Electrons has a what? Charges. After then, G, gravitational force. Force is given, that force will be have the same what the Newton, meter square and kilogram square into mass of proton we are taking in kilogram and also in a kilogram. So what is remaining? It is going to cancel out Newton meter square, exactly, and it is going to cancel out the what is remaining only, that there is remaining only coulomb inverse square. Yes. Hence the given ratio is dimensionless. Given ratio is dimensionless, yes or no? Yeah, because what is E square? E square we can take coulomb square and coulomb square. The what is coming? Zero, that it is dimensionless. Dimensionless. And now the numerical value of the given ratio is, then you can find out the value, because electron is 1.6 and 10 raised to power minus 19 coulomb. G value is 6.67 10 raised to minus 11. And the already what? K value is 9 into 10 raised to power minus 9, and the M of P and M of E is 9.1 10 raised to power 31, and 1 is 1.66 into 10 raised to power minus 27. Put the value and you can find the. Okay, just I'm writing here what are the values for this. K E square, yes, upon G M E M P. K value is 9 into 10 raised to power 9. E value is what? 1.6 into 10 raised to power minus 19, and it is giving the whole square, divide by G. G is what? G value is 6.67 into 10 raised to power minus 11 into mass of electron, that is 9.1 into 10 raised to power minus 31 into what is 1.67 into 10 raised to power minus 27. Then you will solve this, then you can find out the value for this one. Okay, yes. Now coming to the question number 4. Question number 4. Explain the meaning of the statement electric charge of a body is quantized. Okay, that we have already discussed about that explaining. And why can one ignore quantization of electric charge when dealing with macroscopic large scale charge? Yes. Then what you can write in this for that electric charges of a body is quantized. Yes. This means 1 to n number of the electrons can be transferred from one body to another body. But they cannot be what? They can only the transferred, that the charges are not transferred in fraction. Hence, and you know very well that because Q is equal to given NE. And N, what is the N? That what 1, 2, 3 and so on. Yes, exactly. Then you can understand the N is never maybe. N can never be 1.5, 2.5. Yes, you know, exactly. So it is quantized. Yes. And the transfer infraction, hence a body posits total charge in integral multiple of the electric charge. And in macroscopic of large scale charges, the charges used are huge as compared to the magnitude of the electric charges. What is the question number 5? When a glass rod is rubbed with a silk cloth, charge appear on both. Yes. A similar phenomena is observed with many other pairs of bodies. Explain how this observation is consistent with the law of conservation of charge. Exactly. That rubbing produces charges of equal magnitude, yes, but opposite nature of the two bodies, because charges are created in pairs. Yes, you know, one is positive and one is negative. After then, they will be cancel out, then it will be, these will be always in pairs. And this phenomenon of charging is called the charging by friction. We have already know friction. One was conduction and the third was insulation. Yes, insulator. And the net charge of the system of two rubbed bodies is zero. Yes, you know, exactly. This is because equal amount of positive charge annihilates each other. When a glass rod is rubbed with a silk cloth, opposite nature charge appear on both the bodies. This phenomena is consistent with the law of conservation of energy. Similar phenomena is observed with many pairs of bodies. Now the question number 6. 4 point charges are here. What? QA, 2 microcoulomb. QB is minus 5 microcoulomb. And QC is 2 microcoulomb and QD is minus 5 microcoulomb are located at the corners of the square ABCD of side 10 cm. Okay. That how it is given, then a corner of squares. That it is a square. QA, QB, QC and QD. And what is there? 2, this is minus 5 and this is 2 and this is minus 5. Okay. And of course microcoulomb. After then, what is this saying? That ABCD of side is 10 cm. How much? 10 cm. What is the force on a charge of 1 microcoulomb placed at a center? When a one charge is also placed in center, 1 microcoulomb. That what is saying, that how much force that this will be and this will be, the how much force 1 microcoulomb will be have. Now students, come to the point. First of all, 1 micropositive. Yes, you know. Yes. And this one is minus 5 and this is 1. And there will be what type of attraction? There will be repulsion and there will be repulsion also. There will be attraction. Yes, you know. Yes, exactly. And you can understand the force of repulsion between charges placed at corner A. Yes, they are repulsing, and between the charges at C and they are attracting each others. Thank you. Now see how much force it will be apply here. It will be apply and the force will be that in this A side and they will be cancel out, yes or no? And in same place both are in this will be then this and this will be in this way. And what will be the, it will be cancel out this one and it will be the cancel out because the same magnitude applying the both directions, the both directions, yes or no? Yes, just I am giving you the proper definition that force of the repulsion between charges, yes exactly. A and center is O is the magnitude but opposite in directions, yes or no? Exactly, they will be cancel out, yes. Similarly the force of attraction between the charges with the center O and the applying the one in the both are the opposite in directions, so they will be cancel out. So net charge will be, the net force will be at the center O is zero. O is zero. Force is zero. Now come to the question number 7. An electrostatic field line in a continuous curve. That is, a field line cannot have sudden break, why not? An electrostatic field line in a continuous curve. Okay, continuous curve. Suppose that this one is the curve. And you know very well that this is the continuous curve. And an electrostatic field line is a continuous curve because a charge experiences a continuous force with trace in an electrostatic field. The field line cannot have sudden break because the charge moves continuously and does not jump from the one point to another point. And if the two lines cross each other at a point, the electric field intensity will show two directions at that point. This is not possible. Okay, yes. And the question number 8. The poor 2 point charges QA is equals to 3 microcoulomb and 1 is minus 3 microcoulomb are located at 20 centimeter apart in vacuum. What is the electric field at the midpoint of the line AB joining to the charges? Joining that you can understand at the axis. One is QA is 3 microcoulomb and second is minus 3 microcoulomb and are the located at the 20 centimeter. How much? 20 centimeter. At the midpoint it is asking the electric field and you know very well that E is equal to due to a positive charge. The net electric field at point this one, the microcoulomb, the Q upon 4 pi epsilon 0 r square, this is your solution and that this one distance is how much? 10. Yes, I know 10 centimeter and then we can write in 10 is 0.1 meter. Yes, I know. Yes, the 10 into 10 to the power minus 12, then you can find the 0.1 and then if you will put the value then you can find the solution E and what will be the direction, then you can understand the positive charge will be the positive to negative, negative charge will be in negative, positive to negative means this one will be in this direction and minus will be in the in this direction. So the net electric field will be how, in which direction? that it will be minus 3 microcoulomb, and the permittivity that you know 9 10 is to power minus 9, and then you will put the value what, and then you can see here the how much electric field will the this one and this one is in same direction, that we will be add e1 plus e2. So we can find out the electric field. And now second is, if the a negative test charge of a magnitude is placed at this point C, what is the force experienced by the test charge? Then you can understand the C point is kept in a midpoint of this one O. And the Q is given how much? 1.5 into 10 raised to power how much is this given? This is given the charge minus 9 coulomb. Test charge which one is given? Minus 9. So what we have to do? The force experienced by the test charge is F is equal to Q into E. And of how much E is applying here? The one, the which was that you've already find out that you can find, multiply that, and you can find the how much force is applying on the test charge. Now come to the question number 9. What is saying? A system has two charges QA and QB, and which one are, what are the same charges, but one is both the Q1 is positive 2.5 into 10 raised to power minus 7 coulomb, and the QB is minus 2.5 into 10 raised to power minus 7 coulomb, located at a point at A is equals to 0, 0 minus 15 centimeter, and B is 0, 0 plus 15 centimeter. Means they are talking about in Z direction. What? They are talking about the in Z direction. Z direction. Yes or no? Yes. What are the total charge and electric dipole moment of the system? Now what they are saying, the how much is the that if I'm just taking in a, I'm just making in a x with this one, then what is given? That A is here. That Z, it is in Z direction, because the X, Y, and if you are taking this Z, A1 point is here, 0, 0 plus 15, and the, this one is in this direction, so 0, 0 minus 15, yes or no? Yes, this way, A and B. And the amount of charge already given, one is positive, that QA is positive, that 2.5 into 10 raised to power minus 7, and this one is minus 2.5 into 10 raised to power minus 7. So you know for the electric potential that the dipole whether one is positive and one is negative, yes or no? Yes. The total charge of the system, then you can understand the what same magnitude is 0, the distance with how much? This one is giving 15 and this one is also 15. That total distance is 30. Yes, in yes or no? 2D, that you know. And what is the dipole? The P is equals to Q into D. क्यू इंटू डी, एंड वॉट इज द क्यू ए? 2.5 इंटू 10^-7, एंड डी इज हाउ मच यू हैव टू टेक? 30 cm. 30 मीन 0.3. देन यू कैन फाइंड आउट द इलेक्ट्रिक डायपोल मोमेंट. Therefore, the electric dipole moment will be, you can consider, along the z-axis. Now, question number 10. Question number 10. So question number 10, what is saying? That electric dipole with dipole moment already is given. What is P into that? Is 4×10^-9 coulomb. 4×10^-9 coulomb is aligned at 30 degree angle. That angle is given, how much? 30 degree. With the direction of a uniform electric field magnitude, electric field E is given, that 5×10^4 Newton coulomb inverse. Calculate the magnitude of the torque acting on the dipole. What is torque? Then we have to find out the torque. You know very well, the student, that what is the formula for torque is such to PE×sin θ. Yes or no? Yes. Already there is given the electric field and P and the angle. Well, what we have to do? That's only we have to put 4×10^-9. Electric field is 5×10^4 and sine 30. Sine 30 value you know very well what? How much? Half. Then you can understand how much is 5×10×10^-5. Then total is coming 10^-4. How much it is coming? 10^-4. Now we have solved the 10 questions related this. Yes, and you can see here there are the 24 questions. Okay, now we will solve the 12 questions, and in your next class we will solve the 12 remaining questions. Question number 11. A polythene piece rubbed with wool is found to have a negative charge. A negative charge, that 3×10^7. 3×10^-7 coulomb. Estimate the number of electron transfer from which to which. Okay. A polythene. Thin piece. What we are rubbing with wool? With the wool. It's found to have a negative charge. Okay. With wool is found to have a negative charge of this. Estimate the numbers. What is saying? That estimate the numbers of electron transfer from which to which. And is there a transfer of mass from wool to polythene? Yeah. First of all, the strength, then we will discuss whether it will be transferred the mass. Yes or no? No. Because we know that just they only on And you know very well that charge is quantized. Yes or no? That Q is equals to N into E. N into E. And how much charge is coming is there? That is already given what? 3 into 10 raised to power minus 7 coulomb. And we have to find out the quantity for this. The N is here. And electron, you know that 1.6 into 10 raised to power minus 90 coulomb. Yes. So, and this is what? This is a negatively charged. This is a negatively charged. And also electron is a negatively charged. So, N is coming in a what? Positive. So, 3 into 10 raised to power minus 7 divided by 1.6 into 10 raised to power minus 19. That is coming in. The coulomb is going to cancel out. That 3 upon 1.6 into 10 raised to power 12. Positive 12. Positive 12. And then you can understand how much it is coming. That 1.6 and then you will coming means a point. Therefore, the number of electron transfer from and yes or no? Yes. And the polythene head will become positively charged and polythene becomes negatively charged. Polythene hence will be what? Positive and that it will be negative because the charges are growing from here. Yes or no? And which will be donate the charge? It will be negative. And which will be the accepted the charge? That will be the positive. When polythene is rubbed against with wool, a number of electrons get transferred from wool to polythene. A number of electrons will be, sorry, wool to polythene. Wool to polythene. So, it is going, in the charges are transferring. And which are donating, that is the donator that is positive. And which are acceptor, it is the negative. Yes or no? Yes. So, and the second one, the yes, there is transfer of mass taking place. This is because of electron mass. The total mass transfer polythene from wool, that will be how much? Then it will be that small m is equals to me into n. Yes. And the mass of electron is 9.1 into 10 raised to power 31 minus 31. And n value is coming out the from the question. Then you can find out the how much mass is going to transfer. So, but this is a negligible amount of the mass of transfer from wool to polythene. Wool to polythene. Okay. Yes. Now, coming to the question number 12. Question number 12. What is the question number 12? Two insulated charged copper spheres A and B have their centers separated by the distance of 50 cm. What is the mutual force? Two insulated charge, okay. One spheres. Charge copper sphere. Copper sphere. Insulated. One is an A and B. A and B. And their centers are separated by, their centers are separated by how much? 50 centimeter. What is the mutual force of the electrostatic repulsion of the charge on each is? Repulsion of the charge is. Just I am writing here. Repulsion of the charge is how much? 6.5 into 10 raised to power minus 7 coulomb. And the radii of the A and B are negligible compared to the distance of the separation. Okay, the distance, matlab this one radius is negligible. What is the force of repulsion if each sphere is charged double and the above amount and the distance between them is half? First of all, wait, huh? This time telling you the question. Charge on sphere, then you can understand what is given here. 6.5 10 to the power minus 7 and distance between already given 50 cm.